So I've heard lots about promises to give young people opportunities that they deserve. But it's been really disappointing to see that policies that have been gone back on include many of those about climate change. And I want to know, when are you going to wake up and see that it doesn't matter what opportunities you can give young people if you cannot commit to climate change promises?
And Erin, you're a first-time voter.
I am.
And is this going to be the thing that sways how you vote?
Potentially.
OK. And have you made your mind up yet?
I think I have.
OK, well, we'll let you keep that to yourself for now. Stephen.
Well, of course, energy is a reserved matter to Westminster. We try and do the best that we can.
Nine targets out of 30.
We try and do that our best within the devolved framework as it exists. So firstly, for young people, when it comes to opportunity, young people in Scotland have something that young people in England are deprived of, and that's free university education. And it is a great pity that both the Labour Party, the Conservative Party, and I believe the Lib Dems don't share our aspiration.
Hang on, Stephen, hang on. In fairness, Erin wants to talk about climate change.
But when it comes to
climate, if you don't want to talk about missing climate targets, let's talk about oil and gas licences.
I'm quite happy to talk about climate change. Now, coming on to that.
OK. Well, that's the one thing she wants to hear about, rather than tuition fees.
So when... I think tuition fees are important to
you. They are, but she specifically asked about... OK,
I'm interested in both climate change and tuition fees.
Well, fair enough.
Thank you for that helpful intervention there. But when we're looking at net zero, what really frustrates me is the fact that in Westminster, all we hear about is we need to roll back on it. Net zero is a huge opportunity. It's an opportunity to combat the climate crisis, but it's also an economic opportunity, because what we have the ability to do is to harness our natural resources to create good, sustainable, long-term jobs for the future. Why would anyone not want that to happen? And in Scotland, we've got an abundance of offshore wind potential, green hydrogen potential, carbon capture potential. The future is bright and the future is green. But to make that happen, we need a Westminster system that wants to invest in green energy. The Tories are climate deniers. They're not interested in climate change at all. They're trying to combat it. And the Labour Party have walked away from their £28 billion commitment to green energy. How dare they, betraying our economic future, but also betraying the planet's future. And in its place, they want to create GB energy. But nobody knows what that's going to do. It's not going to sell electricity or energy. It's not going to produce electricity or energy. In fact, I think it's just a company that's going to be an investment arm for the private sector. But perhaps Yvette can do something which Keir Starmer and every other senior Labour politician up till now has failed to do, and clarify exactly how cutting £28 billion from their commitments is going to combat climate change and allow us to hit net zero.
OK, would you also like to answer, Erin, about oil and gas licences? Because the SNP has changed its position on this.
When it comes to oil and gas licences, the answer is very simple. In order to hit net zero, you need people to do that. You need a workforce that is skilled to do that. The workforce that does that, or could do that at the moment, is employed in the oil and gas sector. So you need to make sure that those people's jobs exist for long enough to allow them to transition, or you don't hit net zero. And when we talk about this specific issue, the Labour Party proposals, as they stand, would cost 100,000 jobs in the North Sea sector. So not just getting rid of the £28 billion, independent work from investment analysis. And as politicians, when it comes to experts, we should probably start listening to them if we want to meet our targets. So the Labour Party have not just walked away from their £28 billion green energy commitment, they're also walking away from 100,000 people who can deliver net zero.
Read my lips. No austerity under Labour.
Both Labour and Conservatives are saying that as the baseline for their plans, they involve significant cuts in a whole range of public services.